Greetings, everyone. Thank you very much for inviting me to be part of the Code for Good Summit, especially the Using Tech to Build a Better World speaker series. My name is Selim Tezel, and I'm a member of the MIT App Inventor education team. I have prepared some slides for you, and the URL for that is a bit.ly address you can see below. MITAI-CodeForGood. And in these slides, you can find links to many of the videos and news articles, etc., that I will be making reference to. I would like to today briefly talk about using MIT App Inventor to build a better world. First of all, I want to make sure that everybody is familiar with the MIT App Inventor's coding environment. The coding environment for App Inventor is completely visual. As you can see here on the left side, we have the designer view where you can use a components palette to drag and drop one by one the components that you're going to be using to create an app. And as you're dropping them, you can see in the viewer the app update everything the way that you would like it to be. And here on the very right, you can change the properties of the components that you have been importing. And you can change things like height, width, text features, etc. When you click on the upper right, the blocks button, it will bring you to the actual coding interface. And the language is completely blocks-based. It is like putting puzzle pieces together one by one. And because of the nature of these blocks, it is practically impossible to make syntax errors. And thus, it is very attractive to beginning-level coders. Now, I want to quickly talk about our statistics here. We have about, this is data from about a year ago. We have 10 to 12 million users currently, and they have built 42 million apps, and we enjoy about 1 million monthly active users. And you can also see here some countries' participation in the App Inventor community. Currently, U.S. Has a lead in that, followed by many other countries. Now, I want to briefly talk about our mission. Our most important mission is the democratization of the app development environment. For many years, app development was the specialty of a highly technically trained elite group of programmers. But by making the coding environment very accessible, we hope to level the playing field and make the coding, app coding, possible even for very young children. Another mission we have is creating tools that change young people's perceptions of themselves. They may have been consumers and perceived themselves as consumers for a very long time, but now we would like them to have the concept of a creator, being a creator with this tool. Also during the pandemic, a lot of young people have been feeling a sense of helplessness. And again, we are hoping to shift that to a sense of empowerment. The last mission that I would like to discuss here is promoting computational action. You might ask, what is computational action? It is using the power of computing to make a meaningful social impact. And I'm going to give some examples of that here. The first example is from Mumbai, India. There's a slum called the Navi, and in 2014, a nonprofit was founded with the aim of teaching young girls programming and specifically building applications, apps. And they used MIT App Inventor for this purpose. The girls created some very interesting community-related applications, such as coordination of garbage collection, learning math, English, Hindi skills, especially for those who do not have access to education, apps about women's safety, and apps about coordinating water collection, so there are no long lines in their community. Google awarded this effort with the RISE Award. The next example is called Hello Navi. It's from Los Fresnos, Texas, Resaca Middle School. Six girls decided to help a blind classmate who was having difficulty navigating the school environment. So they created for him a school navigation app. This was one of the participants in the Verizon Innovative App Challenge and became a finalist. And in 2014, the team met President Obama at the White House at a science fair. The next example is from Hong Kong. Middle schools from Hong Kong created a dementia care companion app. And their hope was to alleviate some of the challenges faced by dementia patients. In 2017, this effort won the Technovation Grand Prize. They created apps with features that have things like alarms, locator functions, caregiver tips, games to test and exercise mental functions, humanized messages recorded by family member voices, etc. This was a fantastic effort by these middle school students. On this occasion, I also want to mention that Hong Kong is one of the first territories in which we are hoping to have the entire school system adapt and use MIT App Inventor. This is a joint effort with the Hong Kong Jockey Club in a project called Cool Think. The last example I want to give is called Tethys. You may have heard of Gitanjali Rao. She, about 3 years ago, became very interested in Flint, Michigan's lead poisoning situation. And she developed a tool, a device to detect lead in drinking water. Using MIT App Inventor, she created an app with the help of Bluetooth technology that communicated with the device and informed the user if the drinking water is safe or not. Since then, Gitanjali's scientific career really took off, and you may have seen that Time magazine this year announced her as the first ever kid of the year. And there's a fantastic interview that I linked for your leisure, at your leisure you could read. Now I want to quickly talk about some of the more current efforts that we have. With the start of the pandemic, we began what is called the Coronavirus App Challenge. And we invited our community, global community of app developers, to create apps that can alleviate some of the challenges related to the pandemic. For example, people creating apps informing about the facts of the virus or connecting people in cases of emergency, letting people know about volunteer opportunities in the community, etc. Especially in the first months of the pandemic, this was a very, very popular contest, and we had submissions from all over the world, and we have the apps, the winning apps, displayed off our main App Inventor website. This effort led to a bigger effort called the App Inventor Hackathon, sometimes called the Global Appathon for Good. Here we wanted to keep the team broader, so we allowed the participants to create apps in any one of the following categories of global interest. Things like climate change, ending poverty, healthcare, social and racial justice, etc. This was a very popular event, about 1,100 people registered. You can see here the age distribution. Our median age of participation was 16, but it had participation from people all the way up to people in their 70s. Many countries, 71 countries, participated in this contest. India taking the lead here, followed by US, but we had representation in terms of teams and individuals from many countries. I want to quickly mention to you the links that I have put here for some of the media reaction to these events. MIT News, CNN, Voice of America, they wanted to write stories about the app contests and interview some of the winners. And these make some very interesting reading and viewing. Please take the time when you have a chance to look at them. I want to end with just an example of some of the resources available. We have on the topic of computational action. If you go to our YouTube website, you'll see that there's a tutorial there called End Hunger Now app video tutorial. This is a one-hour tutorial which assumes that you are a beginner-level programmer. And in the course of 1 hour, you learn enough to create an app that uses cloud computing. So in 1 hour, from beginner to all the way up to the level of cloud computing. The aim of the tutorial is to create an app that prevents waste of food, collecting from local restaurants food that is going to go to waste, and sending these to local homeless shelters. Alrighty, this is just a summary of the things we're doing at MIT App Inventor. We are hoping that we are changing the world one app at a time. It's been a pleasure to talk with you, and I wish all the best. Thank you.